just what the doctor ordered. It's our
FCPX Time Displacement
tutorial.
Time displacement gives video creators the ability to generate exciting time warping effects. It works by analyzing your clip to create layers of time distortion in your footage. It might sound complicated, but it's easy to use no matter your skill level. There are a few different categories here, but most of the presets contain the same controls. In each category, the presets differ by the amount of layers in the effect. So this one will have 50 layers. We'll start with this preset and go from there. Orientation adjusts the direction that the effect will travel. We'll select top to bottom. Frame offset adjusts which frames will be used in the time displacement effect. For example, when the value is set to 5, each layer is offset 5 frames from the previous frame. The first frame starts at frame 0, the second at 5, the third from frame 10, and so on. In contrast, when the value is set to negative 5, each layer will be delayed by 5 frames. Layer size adjusts the scale of the effect layers. The value we choose can create a huge difference. Soften edges blurs the edges between the layers. Pay close attention to the viewer as we adjust the value. Additionally, if we set the value to negative, we'll see an interesting result. Notice how the layers fade in between. Intro and outro animation lets us adjust the way the effect will animate in or out. We'll enable it. And we'll use the next 4 controls to edit the intro and outro animations. Intro duration controls how long it will take for the effect to fade in. If we pause on the very first frame, on the left we can see the effect immediately. But on the right, the distortion has not started yet. We'll pause again a few moments later. And again, you can see that on the right, the effect is still fading in. But after a short time, the effect fades in completely, and both sides match. Outro duration controls how long it will take for the effect to fade out. As you can see, with outro duration at 100, the effect will begin fading out near the end of the clip. Start offset determines which frame the animation will start on. With start offset at 100, the clip will begin normally, and the effect will come in right on the 100th frame. Also note that the value can go beyond 100 if you type the value manually or drag on it. So play around with it until you get the desired result. End offset determines when the effect will end. So with end offset at 100, the effect ends right at the 100th frame instead of at the end of the media. Now that we've seen how to use this preset, we'll move on, and we'll show you how the other presets work. As we mentioned earlier, we can choose how many points or time layers the preset will contain. Keep in mind that more points may result in longer rendering times, depending on the computing power of your Mac. Here's the difference between 50 points and 400 points. It's a whole different feeling, isn't it? The next category, vertical time displacement, has the same controls as horizontal. The only difference is that the effect lines are vertical rather than horizontal. We'll show you the difference. The next category, radial time displacement, also has the same controls. With these presets, time layers radiate from a central point. Here's how it looks. Luma time displacement creates a much different result because it uses light values for time layers. And it uses the same controls as previous presets we've seen.
Let's see it in action. Isn't that neat?
There's one more preset we haven't covered. RGB time displacement. With RGB time displacement, each of the colors has its own set of controls. We'll use the red channel controls as an example. Red channel displacement determines the set of frames that will be used in the effect. For example, if we increase the value, the red channel data will be pulled from future frames. On the right, this makes the red stand out much more. Randomize red channel, if checked on, randomizes the offset positions of the individual time layers. With the remaining controls, we can customize the effect even further. Randomize mode determines how the randomized values are combined with other parameters, such as the ones highlighted here. Add uses values greater than the default. Subtract uses values less than the default. Add and subtract combines the two. Therefore, each one has a slightly different look. If that sounds confusing, don't worry. Simply use whichever mode looks best for your footage, and know that the results will change based on the other parameters. We'll use add and subtract for our examples. Randomize amount defines the maximum value the randomizer will generate. The higher the value, the more variation we'll see in the time layer effect. Very interesting. Randomize speed adjusts the speed that the time layers will change. There are slight differences in the clip on the right. Randomize noisiness adds an additional layer of variance to the randomized speed. The higher the value, the more erratic the variations. Random seed generates a different random result for the effect. So you can keep generating until you get a desirable result.
Here's what that looks like.
The red channel layers are slightly different in the example on the right. For the green and blue channels, the controls are the same. Here's how it looks if you adjust all three color channel controls. Play around with these to get amazing color time displacement effects of your own.
Some might consider that perfection.